Options for power storage during road trips. Power supply is extremely important, especially during long road trips. The autonomy and comfort of van life is largely dependent on the availability and state of electrical system. Without electricity, there would be no refrigerator, lighting, air conditioner, etc. Building a reliable and safe power supply facilitates van life and also brings convenience to meet modern needs. Most campsites are equipped with electricity supply, but there might not be any along your road journey. Also, there might not be facilities available when one camps in the wilderness. In such situations, having your own power storage would be instrumental to meet your needs. Only by a comprehensive understanding the types and characteristics of batteries can you choose a suitable battery for your car. Batteries are divided into primary battery and secondary battery. Primary batteries, also known as one-time use batteries, can only discharge and be discarded. It is a chemical battery that loses its functionality after a certain level of use. Secondary batteries, also known as rechargeable batteries, can be electrically recharged after use to their original pre-discharge condition. The chemical reaction is then converted into electrical energy, which can be reused. Some of the common batteries are lead acid, nickel cadmium, nickel metal hydride, lithium ion and lithium iron phosphate batteries. Among them, nickel cadmium batteries and nickel hydrogen batteries have memory effect. They are not suitable for use as RV energy storage. Therefore, we analyze only the characteristics of lead acid, lithium ion and lithium iron phosphate batteries. What is a lead acid battery? The lead acid battery was the first battery invented. The electrodes are mainly made of lead and its oxides, and the electrolyte is a battery of sulfuric acid solution. The standard voltage of a single lead acid battery is 2.1 V. Usually 6 lead acid battery modules are used in series to form 12 V. Lead acid batteries should not be discharged more than 50% of their capacity. Otherwise, the aging of the battery will be accelerated and their life will be reduced. Deep cycle batteries, maintenance-free batteries, are designed to discharge up to 60 to 80%. These types of batteries have the same chemical reaction principle, so they are summarized as lead-acid batteries. What is a lithium-ion battery? It uses lithium ions as a key component of its electrochemistry. During charging, lithium ions move from the cathode through the electrolyte to the anode. During discharge, the lithium ions move to the cathode and release energy. There are many different materials for electrodes. A common combination is a combination of lithium cobalt oxide, cathode, and graphite anode. This most commonly found in portable electronic devices such as cell phones and laptops. What is a lithium iron phosphate battery? Unlike lithium ion, lithium iron phosphate batteries have a longer lifespan. It also has excellent thermal and chemical stability, improving battery safety. No cobalt is used in the composition, no worries with the problem of limited cobalt resource on Earth. Therefore, more and more automobiles manufacturers are optimistic about the application of lithium iron phosphate batteries. Energy density, depth of discharge, cycle life, price. Safety, memory, self-discharge, internal resistance. We will analyze 8 characteristics to pick the most suitable battery for van life road trips. 1. Energy density, means how much energy a battery contain while keeping the weight the same. Batteries with high energy density will be lighter than batteries with low energy density. This measurement is usually expressed in watt hours per kilogram. On the condition of storing 2.5 kilowatt hours of electricity, the energy density of the lead acid battery is 40 Wh/kg. Calculated weight is 62.5 kilograms. Lithium iron phosphate battery has an energy density of 160 Wh/kg. Calculated weight is 15.6 kilograms. Li-ion battery has an energy density of 195 Wh/kg. Calculated weight is 12.8 kilograms. With the same amount of power storage, the lead-acid battery is about 50 kilograms more than the other two batteries. The fuel consumption cost of the car will increase. The battery will be moved around frequently for use and charging. The average adult can carry a weight of 20 kilograms, and beyond that, one is prone to injury. Assuming that 62.5 kilograms of lead-acid battery is used, 3 people are required to carry them, which is quite inconvenient. 2. Depth of discharge. Blue represents battery capacity. The depth of discharge is 90%, and the remaining state of charge is 10%. Power per effective discharge equals depth of discharge x total battery capacity. Lead-acid batteries have a depth of discharge of 50%. To put it simply, lead-acid batteries are only half usable. 90% depth of discharge for lithium-ion batteries. That is, 90% can be used. The lithium iron phosphate battery has a depth of discharge of 95%. That is, 95% can be used. In terms of depth of discharge, lead-acid batteries are very uneconomical. Lithium iron phosphate batteries perform best, then lithium batteries, and finally lead-acid batteries. 3. Battery life cycle. Suppose you have a lithium-ion battery. With one charging cycle of 0% to 100% charge. Lithium-ion battery. The charge and discharge life is 500 times. Lithium iron phosphate battery. The charge and discharge life of lithium iron phosphate battery reaches 2000 times. At this point, there is still 95% capacity. Its ideal life cycle can reach more than 3000 times. Lead acid batteries. Life cycle cannot be calculated fully due to depth of discharge, limited usable battery. It is estimated that lead acid battery will be good for 500 to 800 cycles. In conclusion, in terms of service life, the longer the cycle life, the longer the durability. Lithium iron phosphate, lithium ion lead acid. 4. Price. According to Wikipedia, the price cost of lead acid battery is $61 to $156 per kilowatt hour. It is much cheaper than lithium ion batteries at $385/kilowatt hour. Although the initial purchase cost of lithium ion and lithium iron phosphate batteries is higher than that of lead acid batteries. In a bigger picture, it is still cheaper than lead acid batteries in terms of service life and transportation costs. According to Bloomberg New Energy Finance's annual battery price survey, lithium-ion battery pack prices above $1,000 per kilowatt hour in 2010, but in 2020 the price decreased by 89% to $137/kilowatt hour. The report also listed lithium iron phosphate batteries as a cost-competitive alternative, with the cheapest source price of $80/kilowatt hour. 5. Safety. Lead-acid batteries releases sulfuric acid molecules into the air when they are charged. It irritates the respiratory tract, so there should be good ventilation when charging. Lithium-ion batteries also have high safety concerns because they contain flammable electrolytes. Damage of high temperature due to short circuit will cause the battery to burn, or even explode in severe cases. In a research report by Sandia National Laboratories, the temperature rise of lithium cobalt, LCO, and lithium nickel cobalt aluminum oxide, NCA, is about 470 degrees Celsius per minute, and the temperature rise of nickel, manganese, and cobalt, NMC, is 200 degrees Celsius per minute. While lithium iron phosphate, LFP, temperature rises 1.5 degrees Celsius per minute. It is found that the energy released by the thermal abnormality of lithium iron phosphate is very low. As such, there will not be any explosion due to overcharge and discharge, short circuit, etc. This is also the reason why the most RV campervan chooses lithium iron phosphate batteries. 6. Memory effect. When the battery is not fully charged and discharged, crystals are gradually produced which hinder the chemical reaction of the positive and negative electrodes. As a result, the energy density is reduced, and the capacity of the battery will be reduced accordingly. Lithium-ion batteries and lithium-iron phosphate batteries have almost no memory effect. And lead-acid batteries have a similar memory effect problem, sulfation. Sulfation is the enemy of all lead-acid batteries. Whether it is AGM or deep-cycle lead-acid batteries, there will be capacity fading due to sulfation. Because the negative plate of the battery is coated with lead sulfate crystals, which result in a low discharge capacity. When using lead-acid batteries, you need to pay attention to charging them in time after a full discharge. The battery should not be empty for a long period of time. The greater the depth of discharge, the shorter the battery life. 7. Self-discharge of the battery. This is a phenomenon in batteries where internal chemical reactions reduce the charge stored in the battery. Even without any connection between the electrodes, the battery loses power. The rate of self-discharge will vary depending on battery type, ambient temperature, and other factors. According to the data, the self-discharge rate of lead-acid batteries is about 320% per month. Li-ion battery about 0.35-2.5%. LFP-04 battery below 3%. Among the three batteries, the self-discharge of lithium-ion battery and lithium iron phosphate battery is much better than that of lead-acid battery. 8. Internal resistance. It is an important technical indicator to measure battery performance. It represents resistance to current flow. A lower resistance means less opposing force. When connected to the power supply, the internal resistance will consume a part of the electrical energy and in turn generate heat loss. When charging and discharging, it will repeatedly cause energy loss. Under the same 100Ah specification, the internal resistance of the lead-acid battery is 5 milliohm. The internal resistance of a Li-ion battery is about 50 milliohm. The internal resistance of the lithium iron phosphate battery is 1.2 milliohm. The internal resistance value is accumulated when connected in series, taking 24V specification as an example. The internal resistance of a lithium ion battery is 0.1 ohms. The internal resistance of a lead acid battery is 0.01 ohms. The internal resistance of lithium iron phosphate battery is 0.0024 ohms. Calculated with 1 kilowatt hour, which is 1000 Wh. According to W equals VA, the current is 41.6 Ah total. Since the internal resistance will generate heat energy, the lost heat energy is calculated according to the electric power formula. P equals I superscript 2 asterisk R. This R is the internal resistance. When charging, you know that. The internal resistance loss of the lithium-ion battery is 173 Wh, and the loss rate is 17.3%. The internal resistance loss of the lead-acid battery is 17.3 Wh, and the loss rate is 1.73%. The internal resistance loss of the lithium iron phosphate battery is 14.15 Wh, and the loss rate is 0.415%. Taking into account charging and discharging, the losses due to the internal resistance are doubled. So when choosing a battery, also do take into account the difference in electricity bills due to internal resistance losses. The voltage of a single lithium iron phosphate battery is 3.2 V. Connect a few in series and parallel to form 12.8 V or 25.6 V. i.e. 12 V or 24 V power system. With the same number of batteries, consider a 12V and 24V connection like this. Which is more efficient? Safer? Allow for simultaneous use of more appliances? Efficiency. The thickness of the wire affects the amount of current that can pass through. A low voltage of 12V requires more current to produce the same power. Therefore, when the thickness of the electrical specifications and wires are the same, the power of 12V is smaller than that of 24V. Take a pot of 600 cubic centimeters hot water as an example. With 24V, it only takes 20 minutes. With 12V, it takes 40 minutes. Safety. With 24V and 12V, one may think that a lower voltage is safer, but the opposite is true. The thickness of the copper wire in a wire is related to the amount of current it can hold. Thin copper wire carry less current. Therefore, the 12V system needs a thicker wire diameter to withstand large currents, W equals VA. With the same power, the current load of 24V is lower, and it is safer to use than 12V. More uses. 12V circuits are commonly found in small vehicles. It is suitable for low-power appliances such as USB car chargers. 24V systems are mainly used by trucks, large vehicles. Since trucks drivers spend a long time in their vehicles, they use a large range of vehicle electrical appliances. There is more options for van life and road trips. By the way, I personally think that the van life battery should not be incorporated into the electrical system of the car. Even with an isolator, it is still very possible to exceed the load of the car generator, which hinders the starting of the car. In recent years, forest fires are becoming frequent due to fires with camping. And more people are cooking with an open flame. To add on, solar power technology is improving. One can harness and store energy within batteries in the car to be self-sufficient. For road trips, van life, cooking, adjusting the temperature, and using electrical appliances. Have a holistic understanding of electricity use and choose a suitable battery. Bringing comfort and sustainability to your camper life, it will be worth all the time and study.